Hey kids, it's Englantine here. Now I found this fun little article, and it's about this guy, Elijah Villain, or Villain, that's how his name is spelled. And he has basically photoshopped and redesigned a lot of superhero movie posters to star black actors. Now the article itself begs the question, is the world ready for a black Superman? Is it? I don't know. I know that some people would be like, oh yeah, let's go, I think yes. I think overall the world is. I think the America would embrace the hell out of that. Sure, some of us would want to be purist. Are you kidding me? He's been white since 1938. Why should you change him? Why do that? And some people would embrace it only because he's black. And that's all. Which I find equally racist myself. Now, Clark Kent, Superman, first of all, this is the way you play it. The best ever, right there. Anyway, I think part of the pushback is because we have recorded. You know, it's not like a play. A play can come in, you can have any actor, whatever, in it, and it goes out. And if you saw it, you saw it. If you didn't, you didn't. Superman has been recorded since 1938 to be a white character. So when people hear, hey, we're going to race swap, people, wait a second, that's not how it's been for the last 75 years. When Michael B. Jordan was cast as the Human Torch, a lot of the people said, hey, all those comic geeks are racist because they don't want Michael. No, we didn't care. He's a good actor. We just thought that Mara Wilson's character should have been played by a black girl, too, because they were twins. Overall, the majority of comic geeks, I think, just want good casting. That's all. Now, is the world ready for a black Superman? Yeah, I think, like I said, America could take it. Cast a white actor as a black character, like Black Panther or something like that, and I think someone's going to war over it. Now, on one hand, if you ask me, would I like a black Superman? I would have to say, like I said, I don't care, because it would be like a play. But on the other hand, no, I don't. No, I really don't. I know just by saying that, every SJW that listens to this to complain in the comments, heads just exploded and they stopped so they can tell me how much of a racist I am. But let me explain why I don't want a black Superman. Because I would rather see a movie featuring Icon. I'm sorry, guys, but I don't think we're going to be promoting black characters if we keep on just putting black actors in white character roles. I mean, the famous ones have been around forever. How about we let other characters break through? Write some good movies around some of these strong black characters. Anthony Mackie has to be raring to go now. I mean, he's got a chance to not only bust out in his own movie, but we could actually make Falcon a character. I know Marvel has no interest in it. They want to bury him along and call him Captain America, make the white character more famous, just put a black face on him. But you can actually make a black character famous now. He's already got a push. And I've been called a racist for just suggesting that Sam Wilson was his own man as the Falcon. And for Warner Brothers, Milestone Comics is a goldmine for minority superheroes. I mean, come on. How many of you millennials remember the Static Shock cartoon? I mean, why is this not a movie already? Tech Nine can be the Milestone's answer to the Punisher. And Vixen has been primed. She's ready to go now. Now, if you notice, I've been mentioning DC. It's because I've actually had a couple of correspondence with Marvel creators, and they're not interested in promoting black characters. Like I said, they're just interested in putting blackface on white characters. Hope you enjoy Black Panther, because from what I've been seeing and hearing, we aren't going to get too many others. So anyway, those are my reasons. I'd rather see black characters promoted than white characters changed into black actors. That being said, let's take a look at some of these posters, because they're actually done pretty well and look pretty cool. Comic book movies have a history of changing characters' races and ethnicities in movies and TV shows. The casting of black actors like Michael B. Jordan as a Human Torch in Fantastic Four and Lawrence Fishburne as Perry White in Man of Steel has caused some controversy. The question on everyone's mind is whether or not a change of race changes the character. For example, is Superman Clark Kent the same character if he's played by Will Smith, or can Michael J. White replace Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, which would be awesome? Has done some Photoshop. Okay, Elijah Villain has done some Photoshopping and given us a good idea of what we could expect had the casting been different. No, he shows us what they look like, not what they would act like. Looks are not character. That's the Marvel way of thinking. First up, Rosario Dawson is Aeon Flux. I could take this. I know she's a good dramatic actress. She's also, pretty easy on the eyes. Frankly, I could watch her just read the freaking phone book. But yeah, that would actually be a good casting right there. Makkad Brooks, who plays Jimmy Olsen on Supergirl, could he play Captain America? He's got the looks. I mean, the man is like 9,000 feet tall. Does he have the gravitas? Well, for that matter, does Chris Evans? Okay, Will Smith is Batman? No. Bruce Wayne abso-freaking-lutely. However, if I think Batman, and I'm going to go with a black actor, Idris Elba. Dude, he could be menacing and charming. That Idris Elba for Batman, in my opinion. Will Smith, Bruce Wayne, fine. Batman, no. Plus, does he have room in the cowl for his ears? This, on the other hand, absolutely. Yes, you would probably change his origin. I don't know if Iowa Farm Boy would be good. I'm not saying South Philadelphia, but I would change his origin a little bit, make it more suburban rather than rural. But I could see Will Smith as Superman. He could definitely carry it, and he can definitely do the good guy act. Yeah. I mean, you'd have to get away from the fact that he's Will Smith. We all know he's a good actor, but unfortunately, these days, he's Will Smith. I mean, it's just hard to... That's his mountain to overcome, is to get people out of who he is so he can really do a good acting job and create a character that is not Will Smith. Michael Ealy is Star-Lord? Now, here's my problem with this one, is that Michael Ealy's always that guy. It's like, you don't remember what he's been in until you look at his IMDb page. So I don't know if he can be charming and memorable enough for Star-Lord. That being said, Chris Pratt was that dude from Parks and Recreation. So, it might be his breakout. On the other hand, it might just be one more movie that Michael Ealy's in, and then you have to be reminded he was in it. Jamie Foxx's Punisher? Yes! Why is this not being made? Oh, yeah, because they also found an awesome Punisher for TV. Yes, yes, 10 times. I would love to see this movie. Sanaa Lane is beautiful. Let's get that out there. And I think she's a good actress. And she was one of the bright spots of Aliens vs. Predator. But she's also 40. And you might get one movie out of her. As an actress, if they did it 10 years ago, I would say yes. Now, you got to go younger, guys. This one's just a give me. I mean, they've mentioned him for the role before. And, people think, okay, maybe his Miles or his uncle as he's been played. But, yeah, I would try someone else. I would go Shameik Moore from Dope. Or, what is his name? Tyler James Williams from Everybody Hates Chris and Walking Dead. Donald Glover's excellent. Don't get me wrong. It's just I want to pick somebody who hasn't already been mentioned. Okay, appearances, I want this guy now, as far as Wolverine, because I know he could do a great job, but I've actually never seen him, except for Black Dynamite, in anything that really shows that he's got the acting chops. I mean, he's a great TV actor, but I don't think he can hold the screen. This is the same thing as Sanaa. Angela Bassett as Wonder Woman, go back 20 years, and yeah, you got her. But now, you're just talking about an age thing. Candace Patton, maybe, from The Flash? Perhaps she could do a good job. Lance Reddick as Professor Xavier is another version of here, take my money, why isn't this not already a thing? I mean, that's actually good casting. He's, if y'all saw John Wick, he's the guy at the hotel that, the bellman at the hotel. He's got the look, and he can act. That's always a plus. Okay, Lupita, I can't ever say her name right. She is a great actress. However, Storm has been played by a black actress. So this is just recasting, and it's good recasting. It's just not doing the race-swapping thing. So yeah, I would never pick race-swapping over promoting actual black characters. It's time to bring them to the front. I mean, when they say we need more black characters, they're out there. Let's get them out there. Yeah, no need to put a black face on a white character. Let's promote the black character. That's how I feel. That being said, some of those were actually fun. I liked going through them. Some of the posters looked pretty good, and the casting was done pretty well. But that's just my opinion. What did you think? Did you like the posters? Did you not like the posters? What do you think about race swapping versus promoting original black characters? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you like this video, you want to see more, click like, click share, and don't forget to hit subscribe if you haven't done that already, and click that notification bell so you don't miss anything. And if you don't mind, head on over to our Patreon page or our vidme.com. Drop a dollar into the till to help us keep this train rolling and help us keep our lights on. We definitely appreciate that. I'd like to thank everybody who's already done that, everybody who will do that, and to everyone, thank you very, very much for watching. Fight the criminal, chase the bad guy, save the world, follow